release all the tension of the previous activity. After writing that report, no matter how, it just, you feel, I would like you to release and say, okay, I'm moving now, so I'm gonna get back my excitement for the next activity. My friends, hope you are doing great, and in this video I would like you to join me to practice a habit that helps you and me to sustain our focus, energy and excitement throughout the day. And you can use the same habit to help you to sustain your performance throughout the week, throughout the month and throughout the year and even your life. And today the context is going to be in a day, so I would like you to have with you pen and paper so we can do some drawing and some kind of like planning to practice this activity. To give you a context, why should we have this habit? Let's think about some moments in your life that you finished an activity and then you felt exhausted, and then you move to another activity. You felt that the exhaustion still with you and influence on your behaviors and the performance of you and another activity. I'll just give a really small example. You finished work and you felt exhausted, and then you had that kind of exhaustion brought back home, and when you with your family, you were not really fully happy. You somehow maybe even got angry or a bit like grumpy. So that's why we need to master the transition between the two different activities so we can sustain our performance, our excitement. So if you have that pen and paper with you, just imagine that you have three main activities throughout your morning, and you can do the same for your afternoon and your evening. If you have three main activities in the morning, for example, you need to finish a really awesome report, and the second activity, you need to persuade your client to sign a contract with your company, or the next one, you have a really wonderful conversation with your team to understand more about them. Three main activities. So now I would like you to allocate each activity in different block time. For example, from 8:30 to 9:30, writing, finishing the awesome report, and from 10 a.m. to 11, meeting your customer, persuade them to sign the contract with your company, and from 11:30 to 12:30, having awesome conversation with your team. So you can notice that you allocate different activities in different block time, and you will fully focusing on the activity at that time. But between the activities, you have the gap, and the gap time is a time where you can practice this habit. I would like to challenge you to walk 100 steps between two different activities. So after finishing your report, walk 100 steps. And after finishing talking with your client, walk 100 steps. And why 100 steps? Because when we have a number, our brain tends to take action. And with that, you can learn and practice and make that habit to become a part of you. Maybe easier and faster because you have a number, you know what exactly you need to do. So if you walk 100 steps between the activity, I would like you to release all the tension of the previous activity. After writing that report, no matter how it just you feel, I would like you to release and say, okay, I'm moving now, so I'm gonna get back my excitement for the next activity and set the intention for the next activity. After the report, okay, it's done. Okay, now is the time to prepare to give my client the best moment when they talk to me, the excitement that after they talk to me. Set the intention for that and release all the feeling, the negativity or other kind of concern from previous activity, because you don't want to just kind of have the domino feeling from one bad feeling go to the next bad feeling. You want to have excitement and then another excitement and another excitement, and that where you can practice this habit, mastering the transition between different activities by going for a walk 100 steps. And if you say, oh, walking, I'm not really a fan of walking, so maybe you are a fan of meditation, awesome, do the meditation between the activities, release energy and set intention. Or maybe you say, I'm not really a fan of walking, but I like to talk with somebody, a stranger on the street, yeah, go to do that. The idea is that you release the tension and set the intention for the next activity. And when you try it out, the 100 step or the meditation or the talking with a stranger, you will see which one is the best for you. But that is the idea of the habit. Master the transition between different activities so you can reset your excitement for each activity, and you can reset your focus, your energy, and with that you will be non-stop taking action and non-stop loving, living and giving every single moment of life. Oh yes, my friends, before you go, don't forget to support our channel by clicking on the subscribe button, and also to get the most updated videos on personal and leadership development. And yes, most important thing is to implement all the tips that I share. Then share your tips with us, and also share with your friends, so we all can take action together. We all can every day be non-stop loving, living and giving every single moment of life. Love you.